very large tornado on the ground right now.
We were all screaming and praying.
Couldn't get to my child and my son, my child and my wife.
Tornadoes terrorizing Alabama.
Three tornadoes are on the ground right now.
A day of destruction we will never forget.
Never seen anything like it. It was a horrific time, really horrific.
62 tornadoes.
We have confirmed that there are multiple fatalities.
238 dead in one day.
I mean, they were buried under this stuff. So, you know, I just dig.
More than 2,000 hurt. Could more have been done? Meteorologists predicted the historic outbreak.
Meteorologist Jerry Tracy and our other meteorologists saying all week that conditions are ripe for this storm to do just what it's doing.
And told you when to take shelter.
It is very close to Hackleburg as we speak here. So you folks in Hackleburg really need to be in your safe place until this thing passes.
But that information came too late for many. Now, with the latest technology, a new line of defense, the most accurate information in seconds.
A time advantage over everybody else in the Birmingham area.
WVTM 13 Live Doppler, seeing the storm first, saving lives.
Where we stand right now will change the way we predict weather.
You are looking at the only live Doppler radar on television in central Alabama, the WVTM 13 Live Doppler. It's a new line of defense against dangerous storms, protection where there was none before, and it's going to save your life.
The WVTM 13 Live Doppler can see storms moving in from the west better than even the National Weather Service. That information could have made a huge difference for them and for us back in 2011. This is one of the 62 tornadoes that roared into Alabama on April 27, 2011. This is what thousands saw heading their way. And this is what the National Weather Service saw, using information gathered from Doppler radar, a tool vital to predicting storms.
If you want to compare it to, say, you know, a doctor looking at a patient, this is kind of our X-ray or our MRI. It allows us to see what's really going on, you know, in depth.
But there are limitations. The data collected depends on where radars are located.
You know, our radar is way over here, I-65. So this is the Tuscaloosa, what would become the Tuscaloosa tornado.
The next closest radars are in Columbus and Jackson, Mississippi.
You'd have a better look at this storm coming out of West Alabama if your radar is somewhere in between.
And that's exactly where the WVTM 13 Live Doppler is located, near Vance, between Birmingham and Tuscaloosa. It is the only live radar on television, pinpointing storms right now with no delay. You'll be able to see tornadoes as they form. It shows up as a hook echo and upside down comma.
You get that real bright spot, so to speak, and that indicates it's not just rain that's falling, it's not just rain and hail. It's literally pieces of people's lives that are coming down now.
On April 27, 2011, we had information on tornadoes moving in, but they moved so fast, up to 60 miles per hour. By the time we got the data, it was old and the tornado had already moved on. WVTM 13 Live Doppler will track tornadoes in real time. The closer a radar is to a storm, the closer to the ground it can see, and the better we can predict where a tornado will strike. That's the WVTM 13 Live Doppler advantage.
Having data from a source farther west would absolutely allow you to see what's going on in the low levels, which is very important for looking at tornadoes.
The more information we have about a storm, the more information you'll have, giving you more time to prepare, more time to seek shelter, and more time to keep your family safe. So this really is a game changer. We will share the information we get from the WVTM 13 Live Doppler with the National Weather Service so they can monitor these storms in more detail when issuing warnings. And that's not all. We're also working to get our WVTM 13 Live Doppler available to hospitals and other agencies so they can get life-saving information in real time.
The WVTM 13 Live Doppler means we can warn you sooner than ever. It looks like a simple structure, almost like a soccer ball on top of those steel beams, but it's much more than that.
So you know, the structure supporting and protecting it have to be sturdy. All in all, it took over a year.
And then putting up the tower and the radome on top of that took 75 local workers about 3 months.
It's a sight you can't miss as you drive down 2059 between Tuscaloosa and Birmingham. Seen from either direction, the WVTM 13 Live Doppler. But something this massive and this high tech doesn't happen overnight. It began in 2016 when WVTM 13 bought the land near Vance, 1.5 acres.
This was all a thick wooded area that had to be cleared.
That alone was an undertaking. At first, the field of cleared earth was just dirt thanks to a summer of drought. And then the rain came and that dirt turned to a deep mud.
And then 12 dump truck loads of gravel was brought in.
Next came the heavy equipment and the pieces that would become the 110-foot tower. Construction took about a month. Next, putting together the radar on site.
This is the radome behind me. It was actually brought to the tower site in 26 different parts, put together with 800 bolts and weighs 7,500 pounds. You can now see the radome, which houses the radar equipment, is being lifted into the air by a 75-ton crane, higher than our 11-story radar tower, well above the tree line, and you can see far beyond the state line.
After ensuring the winds were calm, it took crews less than a half an hour to secure the WVTM 13 live Doppler on top of the tower.
You know, I was here when they lifted that radome. The structure is so big, it definitely took some prior planning. And it was also windy that day, so we had to wait for the winds to calm down and conditions to be just right. So when they lifted the radome, it was well under control.
Looking up that high, the radome doesn't look so big, but standing next to it while it was on the ground really puts things into perspective.
And Jerry, we've spared no expense. Our parent company, Hearst Television, has spent well over $1 million on this state-of-the-art technology.
It gives us the most accurate, most detailed, life-saving information faster than any other TV station in central Alabama. What's more, the WVTM 13 Live Doppler was built right here in Alabama.
Real-time radar information is invaluable.
Here in Enterprise, Alabama, at the Enterprise Electronics Corporation, real-time radar becomes reality. Just about all the components in an EEC radar are manufactured and assembled right here in this facility. Those parts make up the WVTM 13 Live Doppler, which allows you to see the storm first.
You're really just relying right now on the National Weather Service information. You usually have to wait 3 to 4, maybe 5 minutes to get updates from that information.
But not anymore. The WVTM 13 Live Doppler changes that.
By having your own weather radar, you control it. You can provide information and scans as fast as possible. 30 seconds, 45 seconds, 60 seconds.
It's going to give you a real advantage because of the breaking weather scenarios that we have here in Alabama.
You're looking at the inner workings of the radar, whose dome you can see in Tuscaloosa County right off of I-20. It's called a C-band Doppler weather radar system, and it's a game changer for predicting what's heading our way.
Not only can we tell where the storms are and the intensity of the storms, but we can also tell where they're moving and how fast they're moving.
The WVTM 13 Live Doppler means we'll have the most accurate information first. And you'll have the information you need to keep your family safe. And Steph, having visited the facility in Enterprise, Alabama, where they make these radars, an amazing place. They have a lot of retired military working there. This is our radar for Central Alabama, but they make radars for the entire world.
So why did we choose this location for the WVTM 13 Live Doppler? The tornadoes on April 27, 2011 came in two waves, the first of which in the morning, moving to the northeast. Then in the afternoon and evening, long track tornadoes on the ground for a long duration, also moving to the northeast, like the one that went through Tuscaloosa. Notice that many of the tornadoes formed in western Alabama or even back into Mississippi. The WVTM 13 Live Doppler will give us the first look at the storms as they cross into the state.
You can see what a game changer this is for weather prediction and just what the WVTM 13 Live Doppler can do. It's powerful, it's live, and it's going to save lives.
That is so important because Alabama is no stranger to deadly, destructive tornadoes. We all remember April 27, 2011, but there have been many other violent, destructive tornadoes in years past.
You've heard how things move differently in the northern and southern hemisphere. Well, the same holds true for tornadoes. Typically in the northern hemisphere, they rotate a counterclockwise direction. In the southern hemisphere, it's the opposite. The spin is clockwise. You're watching Seeing the Storm First, WVTM 13 Live Doppler.
Built for Alabamians by Alabamians. WVTM 13 Live Doppler. Built for speed, providing real-time information as storms approach. Built for accuracy. accuracy, seeing the critical spots other area radars might miss. Built to save lives, showing the storms first, giving you more time to seek shelter. WVTM 13, making a $1 million investment into the safety of Central Alabama. WVTM 13, Live Doppler. A brand new C-band radar built along Interstate 2059 in Tuscaloosa County. In the path of severe weather as it moves west to east. Now, Central Alabama's most accurate weather team has Central Alabama's most accurate storm tracking technology, giving you the earliest warning when dangerous conditions threaten your community. Unmatched speed, exclusive storm tracking, pinpoint real-time accuracy. Part of WVTM 13's commitment to you. What's happening right now and what's next? WVTM 13 Live Doppler. From today's WVTM 13 News.